My name is Mako Nyako. I'm a deaf Ghanaian. I'm here to give an in-depth knowledge about media literacy. To start off, I'll first fully introduce myself. Second, I'll provide greater clarity about media literacy. For a long time now, I've been working as a teacher, a researcher, and a lecturer. I also produce my own media, such as this video. My work often involves interaction with media to access and use information. I might, for example, watch YouTube to learn something needed for my work. I might then turn to Facebook to read what people have posted about the topic. Here in Ghana, we have a website called Ghana Web, which is a local source of news. There is a lot to learn from there. Aside from work in my free time, I go home and watch TV on my flat screen. From the moment the TV turns on, it's immediately filled with media images. I might also try to connect with my friends on social media platforms such as WhatsApp or Facebook. Or we might use email to discuss and to exchange information. Even when I go out, I'm driving in my car or go to the shop, there are so many media advertisements all over the place. How do I respond to this media? People approach me selling the products being advertised. What do? I feel like media constantly bombards me with an overwhelming amount of information. I see it everywhere I go, every day. For example, when I look at my phone, media is there. When I turn on my TV, it's there. When I go into a supermarket, it's there. From the moment I wake up in the morning until I go to sleep at night. Meaning, media has not only become part of my life, it has become my life. And I can't separate myself from it. Okay, so far you've been viewing this video and seeing the word media, but what does it mean? Media includes the internet, TV, advertisements. It's a very, very long list of things. Now that we have briefly discussed media, we can move our attention over to discuss the word literacy. What does that mean? Myself, when it comes to the word literacy, I think about books and the ability to read, like that. I'll finish explaining the meaning of media and literacy. Media literacy is the ability to read the media, being a media literate. When we put these two words together, what do they mean? Again, as said, media literacy is an ability not only to read the media, but being able to analyze it, to get a critical understanding, and to give an in-depth evaluation. This media literacy was new to me. I really had no idea what it was all about. I decided to look around on YouTube and view many different presentations on media literacy. There wasn't any media literacy video in sign language for the deaf. What did I do? I took this opportunity to make this video to clearly explain this topic for all of you to best understand it. This year, we are very lucky because the United States government, through the Department of State, set up a project called TIES. The project provides training to share media literacy with different countries. Luckily, Ghana is involved. Now, I'll provide an in-depth explanation of what media literacy is all about. According to the National Association of Media Literacy Education, this thing called media literacy consists of abilities to access, analyze, evaluate, act on, and communicate with, and also create media. The point is to help people gain critical understanding of media. Now back to the first component of media literacy, access. What does it mean? Where do you look for your media? What is your go-to source? Where do you find your media? Do you access your media from the internet, from Facebook? Which do you prefer? For example, do you prefer websites like Ghana Web or My Joy Online? Whichever you choose, you know your preferred source to access news or any other kind of media. Next, we have evaluation. What is it? This is about evaluating where the media is from. Who brought these ideas to the table in the first place? What information is being communicated through this media, and what are the ideas and motivations behind it? Is this for business? Is this just somebody posting an experience on Facebook, or is it a political advertisement, or what? We should always try to evaluate media to answer some key questions about it. You may be reading a media story, but what's inside its message, and where exactly did it come from? We also have analysis. Again, media is brought forward, we review it, but we have to ask, what is the quality of it? Do the ideas presented make sense? Are they understandable? In short, do we think the story is true or fake? Here's an example. There was one time I saw a media advertisement for a free hearing aid. I saw the word free and really got excited. I rushed in for it only to discover that only the hearing screening was free if I paid for their hearing aids. This experience demonstrated that we must take time to critically analyze the media to get to the true meaning of its message. We will move on to discuss the word act. So far, we have looked into how we can access, evaluate, and analyze media. This is all well and good. I might access a piece of media, evaluate it, and analyze it. But then, crucially, what am I supposed to do with it? Another example, if I'm in the shop and media is advertising various products being sold, the question is, what should I buy? In short, you need to feel confident enough of your evaluation and analysis of the media that you can act on. We have communication next. Communication. If you really enjoy a media story, what do you do with it? Do you keep it to yourself or repost it? If you forward it onward, how do you send it? Do you attach and upload it to your Facebook page? Or just attach and send through WhatsApp? Or do you try to repost it to your YouTube account? Maybe it's such a beautiful story, you are inspired to send it to your friends and add your comments and photos to it. But media consumers must be careful. Some media story gets can be fake and even discriminatory. So you must carefully select which media you share with other people. Media literacy will help you to know how to do that. Lastly, we have create. Create means creating your own media. An example would be writing and sharing my own stories through various social media platforms. Or another example is, if I access a media story and then add another beautiful story to it, do you put it on Facebook or YouTube? You might want to consider your audience. Who will want to access it? Is it for friends, a girlfriend or boyfriend? These are all important things to consider. What is the purpose behind the creation of media? Are we communicating some good ideas, or is it more about strengthening friendships? This video is an example of media creation. You see me signing, explaining all these points about media literacy. Remember, I couldn't find a video about media literacy on YouTube, and there wasn't any available in sign language. I decided to be the first to create this media and have it here. That is just an example anyway. So in summary, media literacy is a concept that helps us think about and approach the media we consume. Do we just accept anything the media tells us? No, media literacy enables us to think more critically, to really ask, what is this? Is it true or is it fake? After deeper analysis, you need to determine your level of confidence in this information. You might say, no, it's fake, and choose not to accept it. What would you do then? Would you choose to involve yourself in it? Or would you take the story to a different direction with your own comments? Those are the key points to keep in mind. Why is media literacy so important? I mean, this thing, media literacy. So what? Who cares? What does it matter to me anyway? Isn't media just for entertainment? Some people might just read media and feel it doesn't matter. They just accept all of it. No, the key components of media literacy can help us with so much. For example, media literacy can help you find a job. Maybe you see a job advertisement in the media. You read and clearly understand it. You take advantage of the opportunity and get the job. Or maybe use media literacy to develop your social relationships. If you are looking for that love of your life, well, Facebook is there. You might find your future partner who you marry. Or maybe it's just about using media to meet and communicate with new friends around the world. Media literacy can help you find valuable information. You can benefit a lot from all these aspects of media literacy. Deaf people should also get involved in media literacy to interact with the world and keep up with what is happening in it. It is everywhere and everything in our lives. From morning to afternoon to evening into the night, we are surrounded by media. All around us, we see advertisements, we read Facebook, we chat on WhatsApp, we view YouTube. All of this information is more accessible and understandable through media literacy.